Hello everyone, I am Surendra Jain, Master Teacher in Vedantu. I am presenting you the solutions of JEE Advanced 2020. This is question number 5 from paper 2. This question is from the topic functions based on the concept of composite, continuity, differentiability, fractional part. Multiple things they have combined in one question. We usually expect from JEE to give this question, and in fact we have seen this kind of question almost every year or alternate year. Let us see what this question is. Let the functions f minus 1 comma 1 to r and g minus 1 comma 1 to minus 1 comma 1 be defined by fx is equal to mod 2x minus 1 plus mod 2x plus 1 and gx is equal to x minus greatest integer x. Let fog minus 1 comma 1 to r be the composite function defined by f of gx equal to f of gx. Suppose c is the number of points in the interval minus 1 comma 1 at which f of g is not continuous, and suppose d is the number of points in the interval minus 1 comma 1 at which f of g is not differentiable. Then the value of c plus d is. Let us see how to solve this question. So first thing I will discuss here is that this gx function is nothing but fractional part function. And this fractional part function is equal to x if we choose x to be from 0 to 1. And it is periodic with fundamental period is equal to 1. Why I am saying so? I will make use of this fact because it is periodic. So for minus 1 to 0 and 0 to 1, your function should repeat, your graph should be same from minus 1 to 0 and then 0 to 1. So I will be doing the calculation only for 0 to 1, and then we will be using this thing for minus 1 to 0 also. So here f of gx is actually equal to f of fractional part x, okay, and this fractional part x will be x if x is from 0 to 1. Now to write this fx, we are given it is the sum of two mods. Now if x is from 0 to 1, you can easily see this second expression 2x plus 1 will always be positive, so we can just remove this mod without any consideration. But first expression will be positive also, it will be negative also. So if I take x from 0 to half, this will be negative, hence it will be opened with minus sign. So we can write this as 1 minus 2x plus 2x plus 1. This will be for x belongs to 0 comma half. Okay, and for x from half to 1, it will be 2x minus 1 plus 2x plus 1. This is for x belongs to 1 by 2 comma 1. So if we simplify it, we get I think 2 here and 4x here. This 2 will be when x belongs to 0 to half, and this is when x belongs to 1 by 2 comma 1. Now these expressions are very simple, 2 and 4x, so it is very easy to draw the graph of f of gx. Let us see. To draw the graph of f of gx, let us focus on 0 to 1 part. Okay, so first 0 to half, it was 2 for x from 0 to half, so this will be a constant function like thing. Okay, and after 1 by 2, it is 4x, so this formula is also giving us the same value at half, that is 2. So the graph will be going like this. At 1, it is open bracket. In fact, we don't bother about 1 because our domain is from minus 1 to 1 open bracket. Now this is graph from 0 to 1, and because your gx is periodic, so from minus 1 to zero also, we can draw similar graph. So minus 1 to minus half, it will be like this, and then minus half to zero, it will be like this. So this is my graph is for y is equal to f of gx. Now it can be easily seen from minus 1 to 1 on the interval minus 1 to 1, there is only one point of discontinuity, that is x is equal to 0. Because here it is just a corner point, but it is continuous at half and minus half. So only one point of discontinuity at x is equal to 0. Now to get the value of d, that is number of point of non-differentiability, it is 1 from the point of discontinuity and it is 2 from the points where we are getting point of where we are getting corner points. So they are minus half and they are 1/2. So it will be 3. So it will be at x is equal to 0, minus half and half. So the value of c is 1 and the value of d is 3. So the answer for c plus d, so the answer for c plus d should be 4. Okay, that is the final answer. Now I'll tell you one more method for this question. Please see, my fx was given to be mod of 2x minus 1 plus mod of 2x plus 1, and gx is given to be fractional part x, and this we and the interval of consideration is minus 1 to 1. Now fx is always continuous, but gx is not. It is discontinuous only at integral values of x. So in this interval, it is discontinuous only at x is equal to 0. Okay, so if we are taking f of g x, we can expect discontinuity only because of discontinuity of g x, which is at x is equal to 0. So only one point of discontinuity, that will be c, that will give you c equal to 1. Now this fx, we can see if we draw the graph, this fx is non-differentiable at x is equal to 1/2 also, when this will be take value 0, and this will be non-differentiable at minus 1/2 also. Okay, so that means when we consider, we talk about f of gx, it will be non-differentiable at when this gx will be equal to 1/2 or minus 1/2, because gx cannot be equal to minus 1/2, gx can be only 1/2, and it will happen when you take x to be equal to minus half and equal to 1/2. Okay, so this f of gx is non-differentiable at x is equal to minus half and half, and also because of x is equal to 0, because there it is discontinuous. So because of discontinuity, one point of non-differentiability, and because of non-differentiability of this mod function, the sum of two mods, we get non-differentiability point at x is equal to minus half and x is equal to half. So c is 1, d is 3. So the final answer is c plus d is equal to 4. So this is the second method. We can do it one more way. If we make FOG completely without considering the periodicity of GX, it will be little lengthier, but you can see we get similar graph, similar function, and answer will be the same. Okay, so that is all about this question. I hope you have liked this solution. Thank you so much, and stay tuned for the next question. Bye.